Aside from this,
worst job I've ever had. I'm working right now. Don't put that online, I'll get fired. I was at a bank, and I was working in HR and billing, which was a lot of data entry and moving around files. And it was in South Carolina, so it was about 100 degrees, and we were required to wear skirts and pantyhose.
I sold Cutco knives once. It was really horrible, and I had to do that thing where you cut the penny with the scissors, but actually, in fact, you have to be very strong to do that trick. So I would be like, and then the scissors do this thing where I could well, they do it, trust me, don't worry about it, just buy them, please.
I worked in a warehouse where we had to package home drug tests, and we didn't really have to take drug tests to get hired at the job. And it's the only company in the country that manufactures or packages these home drug tests. But I used to do a lot of drugs and then take the drug tests at work for fun to see if they actually worked. And they did.
I worked at a newspaper in West Virginia, which was the only newspaper in the entire county. So I would be typing letters to the editor about, like, Johnny came and brought me a pie today and my grandma's feeling sick. And it would be in this bizarre, like, old lady cursive. And it would take me an hour to decipher this nonsensical letter, and I would do that for like 8 hours a day.
Corn detasseling. Apparently, you have to rip the tassels off of female corn so that the male corn doesn't impregnate them and wreck the corn on the cob. So you're welcome.
I worked as a feeder, which for those people who don't understand medieval jobs, it's cleaning a horse's anus, which involves putting on a large glove and basically just reaching in and scooping out everything that's inside.
Wrapping presents for other people. One of my temp jobs in Chicago, they sent me all the way up to suburban Chicago, and I had to go to this company in the middle of nowhere and wrap people's presents all day. And they would just dump these toys, and I was there for 10 hours wrapping other people's gifts. It was awful. It made me hate Christmas that year.
To be honest, I would like to own sort of like a gay club that during the daytime is a bookstore / novelty store. And that would sort of support me while I write my memoir.
My dream job is what I'm doing. I want to run a theater company, and I want to act with my friends, and I want to work with people who deserve to work, and I want to be able to help people get the opportunity to be seen. I want to be able to, and at the same time, I want to be able to express myself through what I create. Eventually, I'd like to be able to get paid for it.
I guess I would like to own my own lesbian bar at some point. That's everyone's dream job. I know that's so cliche, but I don't know. I hold it close to my heart.
Living professionally on a tropical island. I would like to. Well, I'm about to start doing it. I'm going to be a massage therapist and an actress, and be my own boss. And it's going to be awesome.
Creating a space for other artists to work. It's kind of my big goal is building an artist retreat somewhere in West Virginia.
Well, everybody else's dream jobs have sounded pretty good so far, between the lesbian bar and creating an artist colony. So I might hop on those, but definitely something where I'm creating, making art. that other people would come and enjoy for sure.
I would love to be doing this all the time, full time.
Hey, come see Secretaries May 21st through June 6th. Be a grand time.